Jamaica, the sun was shining every day in Jamaica.
Usain Bolt, Johan Blake, Asafa Powell, the fastest man in the world come from Jamaica. But not every child there dreams of beating everyone else on the track. Football also plays a big role on the Caribbean island. Today, we talk about it. Jamaica, the home of Reggae and Bob Marley. Almost 3 million people live on the island, which is the origin of the Rastafarian religion. The country has been independent from Great Britain since 1962, and the center of the island is the capital, Kingston. As mentioned at the beginning, the country is particularly famous for its strong sprinters. Who can still remember the film Cool Runnings, which was based on the Jamaican bobsled team? Football is not quite so exotic on the island. In 1998, the national team even took part in the World Cup in France, led by captain and goalkeeper Warren Barrett. But before we look at the tournament and the national team, let's first look at the domestic league. The National Premier League has existed since 1973, and Santos FC crowned themselves the first champions. The team remained the dominant team of the 70s and won 5 titles. In the meantime, however, another team has secured the title of record champions. Portmore United FC have won the championship 7 times, most recently in the 2018-19 season. The league consists of a regular season followed by the decisive playoffs. A total of 12 teams take part and 6 qualify for the playoffs. The 2019-20 season started but was then cancelled and not ranked due to the corona pandemic. Then, in May 2021, the Jamaica Football Association announced that the league would restart and the shortened season would run from June to September. The teams were the same as in the aborted season. UWIFC announced its withdrawal as the new fixture schedule clashed with another commitments of the players. In the end, Waterhouse FC and Cavalier FC made it to the playoff final, Cavalier winning on penalties. Fourth place went to Mount Pleasant FC, who had one of the strongest players in their midfield, in Kevon Isaacs. The 25-year-old has also been allowed to play a few times for the national team and gives us a little insight into the Jamaican league.
Our league in Jamaica is not fully professional, based on the fact that it is not being paid that way, but the league, it is very small, it is well organized, well structured. We play that season for approximately 9 months. It's a much condition, I can't complain. It's pretty decent, and we're doing exceptional in the region. So, everything is very good.
Of course, the teams from Jamaica also compete internationally, with the 2 finalists qualifying for the Caribbean Club Championship. There, the teams play a major role, with 2019 even seeing an all-Jamaican final. As winners, Portmore United entered the CONCACAF Champions League. There, however, there was a clear defeat against Mexico's Cruz Azul. So far, no Jamaican team has made it past the first round of the Champions League. In the second most important competition, the CONCACAF League, things are going better. In 2020, Waterhouse FC made it to the quarterfinals, just like the year before. In order to send a representative in 2022, this year's 2 finalists must first win the Caribbean Club Championship. From the 2023-24 season onwards, the CONCACAF Champions League will have a new mood and the chance to participate will be even greater. If you don't want to miss out on all the latest informations, follow my Instagram page Football Worldwide, which is linked below. But enough about the club competitions. Let's talk about Jamaica's national team, in which Kevon has played a few times with top stars from the Premier League like Leon Bailey or Michael Antonio. He ranks for us where the national team stands in comparison to the other CONCACAF nations.
With the other team competing in the region, Italians, I think we have been there about. We have been doing well. We're doing extremely well. The World Cup is a tournament we can use to judge us based on what we have been for. But in the last couple of years, I think we have fallen off. I think still have been catching up to do. Yeah. Compared to the other team in the region, I think we're doing extremely well.
Of course, when it comes to Jamaica, it is also worth taking a look at the history books. It becomes clear that football has a long tradition, with the first international match dating back to 1925. The association has existed even longer, having been founded in 1910. However, it only became a member of FIFA after independence in 1962. They became close to qualifying for the World Cup in 1966 with decisive matches against Mexico and Costa Rica. In the end, there was only one draw and two defeats, so Mexico went to England for the World Cup. Many players left the country in the following years, and the national team was unable to maintain its good level. It was not until the 1990 Caribbean Cup that things started to look up again and Jamaica won the tournament. As a result, they also qualified for the Gold Cup, but did not score any points there. 1998 is probably the golden year of football in Jamaica to this day. They won their preliminary group at the Gold Cup, even though Brazil was in the group at CONCACAF's invitation. Keeper Warren Barrett was the guarantor for the good results. In the semi-finals, they were beaten by Mexico. They also qualified for the World Cup in France, where they finished third in Group H. Their only victory came against Japan, thanks to a brace from Theodore Whitmore. To date, it was the country's only World Cup appearance. More Caribbean Cup titles followed, with 6 titles in total. Since 2015, they have also done well in the Gold Cup, reaching the final twice. They also had one of the strongest Premier League defenders in the squad, Wes Morgan of Leicester City, led the team in the tournaments. At the Gold Cup 2021, they only narrowly lost out to the USA in the quarterfinals. The team now consists almost exclusively of players who play in the bigger leagues in Europe and North America, with only a few players from the domestic league. One of them is Kivon.
Yes, I'm top players in Europe. I think maybe next year. But the national team is another level. It's super professional. Standard is really high. But due to the fact that our clubs, our league is not fully professional, we feel the mainstream standard of our players. And honestly, I think we cannot hold the clubs accountable for that.
Finally, of course, we have to talk about the qualification for the 2022 World Cup in Qatar. Because here, the Reggae boys are still in the running and have made it to the third round. It will be very difficult, however, because they are already 7 points behind Panama in fourth place. This entitles them to take part in the playoffs, where the winner of the Oceania World Cup qualifiers awaits. The national team still has 6 games to play, and the clash with Panama on the 30th of January is eagerly awaited. Kivon hopes to see his country at the World Cup this year.
It's unbelievable that the last time we went to the World Cup was 1998. That was like 23 years ago. But with the talent that we are producing, we should have been to the World Cup another time. We should have won the Gold Cup. But we just have to keep working. We continue to structure our program the right and proper way so that we can get what is deserved for us.
Jamaica. It was a very exciting trip to the Caribbean. I learned a lot and I hope I was able to give you a little insight into the island of Reggae. There are not only great sprinters, but also great footballers. I wish you all a happy new year. I would be very happy if you subscribe to my channel directly in 2022 to continue to accompany me on my journey. Take care and look forward to many more great countries waiting for us.